31.1. Warmer than normal. Less reptile than normal.
Heart rate went from 118 down to 54.
Ooh, 54. Well, that's because you're a runner. You're young.
Yeah. Young.
And fit.
It was a good meditation as well, particularly calm, so.
No, that's good.
That helps. 35. I think I had a dream last night that we came down with COVID.
It's quite high.
A lot of us.
Okay, community stuff.
I got a slight concern about this skulking tomcat that we've seen. I did pick up the kittens the other day. I thought, you're heavier than normal. Both of them are a little bit more kind of doughy. I really hope it's just you're overeating. I really hope it's not.
What can we do?
Yeah. Well, if you see the tom, do more than shoo it away.
What? You mean kill it?
any force that's necessary.
Okay.
Not clinging to anything in the world. That is how a monk dwells, contemplating mind as mind. So we've been looking at the mind and talking about how important the mind is over in different ways. And so that's some of the Buddha's own words as regards mind. So it's kind of like my reading from that is just how it's kind of like, just guard your mind, look after your mind, see where your mind is. And you sort of notice when the mind is contracted, I've got a contracted mind, yeah, or an exalted mind, or a mind with irritation, frustration, just noticing. Okay, that'll do for today. Mind with craving for breakfast.
Nearly 11.
They kind of they don't seem to sell them singularly. It's kind of by six packs. Oh no, the trees. They are trees. Ah yes, it's a plum rootstock. Mm.
Do you think this wire?
I don't know.
You don't know.
No, I just don't know. I mean, it doesn't even seem to appear through here, so I don't know where it goes.
Yeah.
Oh, no. You've got no way of knowing.
It's very old. Okay, well, I'll be careful of that.
Yeah. There's no. Yeah.
SDS?
You're going to have to assume the worst.
Jeez.
I mean, it's live.
So it will be an emergent process, as I'd see it, but the idea being that it is an eco-Buddhist retreat centre with an arts and cultural bias. There's this historic building with its significant roots in literature and the culture of the country, if not the world.
wanting in some ways to honour that with a building that is beautiful, with grounds that are beautiful, and with a community that isn't just about functioning, but it is about, the community is about creating a depth of connection and friendship and warmth and care and transformation. So short term, it's kind of creating a community that's resilient enough to be able to move the building project on, but also that building a sense of working on ourselves, transforming ourselves through this.
Than I thought it was.
This has got, that's a fungal bloom, looks like.
Is it? Yeah. All right, dry rot then.
Guys, bloody, it's just everywhere.
Yeah.
Like, it's sopping wet, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like amazing that it's still...
That it's still solid.
Yeah.
And together, yeah. It's really wet.
Mm. I'll cock that up.
Did it stick? It's to the wrong bit.
Oh, I've got it stuck. But I just need to put more on.
Okay.
More on.
More on.
So this will be what we're out, and it's going to be another. I think.
Jeez. How's today gone? Tell you well.
Yeah. Radiators are on, but I heard.
Radiators are on.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Just really? In time for summer.
What there is
the evenings would be cool.
Potentially hot water, but then we need to get someone to fit the bathroom to use the hot water.
Mm.
And apart from that, I trod on a nail and that hurts.
Oh!
Yeah.
Oh!
Did it go deep?
Don't know.
Tetanus jab.
Well, if my jaw goes. You'll know that I haven't had one.
If your jaw goes like that, it's too late.
Yeah, that tool's like this long. A gypsy instead of a trowel that we've been using that are like this, and you're skimming over it like this, teams or whatever, and you just get that thing and again. But then I met his mum.
Okay. So, take the middle.
Yeah.
Round as it comes here.
Yeah.
Then you do a reef knot. Do you know how to do a reef knot?
Right.
So take it through the belt.
Yeah. Right, oh yeah.
That's it. Pull it nice and tight so it's just flat.
She won't forsake me.
Okay, so have a look at that in the mirror. It's the right hand side.
Okay.
Let me know what you think.
Yeah. That's cool. Okay, again.
So let go of the other one. Yeah, and just
leg over the
leg over.
That's it. And pull it straight in.
So you need to pull that arm up more and then pull your legs together.
That's it.
Okay,
wow. So,
that's good. I like that one.
So do you remember trap and roll, Ben?
Trap and roll?
Trap and roll. So trap his foot, trap his arm and roll.
There are, in our existence, spots of time that with distinct preeminence retain a renovating virtue, whence depressed by false opinion and contentious thought, or aught of heavier or more deadly weight, in trivial occupations and the round of ordinary intercourse, our minds are nourished and invisibly repaired. The morning rose in memorable pomp, glorious as e'er I had beheld. In front, the sea lay laughing at a distance. Near, the solid mountains shone bright as the clouds, grain tinctured, drenched in empyrean light. And in the meadows and the lower grounds was all the sweetness of a common dawn. Dews, vapours, and the melody of birds, and labourers going forth to till the fields. Ah, need I say, dear friend, that to the brim my heart was full. I made no vows, but vows were then made for me. A bond unknown to me was given, that I should be, else sinning greatly, a dedicated spirit. On I walked, in thankful blessedness, which yet survives.
Do you think this was actually modelled off someone's head?
I remember someone said to me a few years ago that the truth will set you free, but first it will piss you off. And I mean, that really rings true for me. In some ways, living here, I can't really escape from myself in the ways that I was able to before. It, like the process of meditating, where you close your eyes and sit still and don't do anything but just observe your thoughts for 40 minutes or an hour, or however long you can actually tolerate that experience. I mean, it's like, it's completely mad, really, isn't it? Why would anybody want to actually look at what's going on? It's like, oh my God! I actually think like that? Oh, shit!
I'm hearing what I'm saying, and I'm hearing me just sounding like a massive stereotypical hippie, so I want to put it in a kind of nuanced way, but the I've experienced different levels of happiness and joy, and there's like kind of instant gratification, and there is also the gratification, a sort of subtler pleasure that comes from patience and discipline and stillness and insight.
The thing about a building site is it throws up a lot of frustrations.
Can someone tell Dan to go away?
Not while he's got that chainsaw in his hand.
But I think, you know, having a good practice of meditation and ethics and, you know, the precepts that we recite every morning, you know, does have an effect. So you end up not feeling like giving people a hard time or not getting too upset or too angry. And seeing frustrations as opportunities rather than a problem. So when, you know, difficult experiences, difficult emotions arrive, negative emotions arise, kind of taking an interest in them and having a kindly attitude to yourself for experiencing it, and maybe to the other person who's stimulating that negative state. So working in meditation with those I find particularly valuable and stops me getting thrown off course.
So the guy who put the money up, the original, what's called angel benefactor, who gave us the, you know, the money to buy the property, and asked, would I take on the project? He has kind of said that he will help fund the project, but he's reluctant to release funds at the moment. His money is in Bitcoin, and Bitcoin is doing pretty well, and he just thinks it's going to keep getting better. Maybe in the long run we might well be okay financially, but in the short term it's a bit worrying, having taken out, you know, £600,000 worth of loans.
I'd imagine we can finish the cottage and the coach house with a bit of luck, so it's like we'll have something. But the main house heats, ground source heat pump, ecological sewage system. There's no point doing anything in this house unless we've got the roof sorted. That's a really major project. God knows how much that would cost. Probably £500,000, maybe. So it's kind of like, oh God, you know, what are we going to do?
You ready to be zapped? Monkey's bum.
It's really wonderful to be here. Really just... You know, I went away for 3 weeks. I stayed away for nearly 4 months. I didn't feel right living in America. You know, just a modern, mundane sort of lifestyle. You know, it's very pleasant, but it isn't very. It's not completely fulfilling. You know, it's very busy. You know, you drive around and you do the shopping and you do the cleaning and the errands and you walk the dogs and. But then I just felt like I was getting lost somewhere. There wasn't a lot of space for me. And so it really became apparent to me that I wanted to come back and that I needed to come back and that this was the right place for me to be. Yeah. Very good. I'm feeling very at peace. So.
I've got this course this weekend that I'm not in the least bit prepared for. All of this tax and insurance stuff that's just come up on my car. And then I've sort of got, you know, I've got to make time for my spiritual friendships and sort of like resolve childhood traumas, get 8 hours of sleep a night, brush my teeth, comb my hair. It's all happening. So, but yeah, still enjoying being here. It's great. It's nice to be with you guys. I feel very supported.
This morning, I was meditating between 8 and 9, and there was some kind of party going on in the corridor.
It wasn't me. It had nothing to do with it.
I said, we need to be quiet, otherwise he'll come out and beat us up.
So yesterday's teaching, as you remember, was about noticing people, taking them in. Yeah. So taking them in also includes taking yourself in. So knowing what's going on with you and how are you looking. Are you looking with an eye of critique? Or are you looking with a kind of curiosity and warmth? So appreciation of oneself and appreciation of others. Here ended today's Dharma input.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Amen.
There's a lot to be said for central heating and having a four-wheel drive vehicle.
What are they? We don't know these things.
They're modern inventions of comfort.
So, Mr. Chiller, how long have you been bathing outside?
You know, I've made bath a lifetime's activity, actually.
Need that yuh at the end, so he is just her air. Okay?
This is how you do a duh. It's just like an ah. You go all the way up. Okay?
Mr. I has a habit of saying his name in kind words. So that word is kind because it's got k, I, and yeah? Even though it hasn't got an air at the end of the word. Well. Unfortunately, because we left the book at your mum's, I can't remember. Because he is such a kind man, add further examples that rhyme with kind later. Okay, so try and write the word kind.
Okay.
You're picking your nose on camera. Uh-oh, look. Show this to your boyfriend when you're 16.
Hi Ben, what's the dates for the music retreat?
23rd to the
31st. To the 23rd to the 31st. Okay, gotcha.
Cool.
Great, thanks.
Alright, bye.
Yeah, so obviously the presence of nature here is like, you can't miss it. It's everywhere. It's like I wake up every morning to the sound of birdsong in all directions. Yeah, it's just like bewildering the amount of birds that are here. So, you know, firstly, that's really special. You know, the land has so much on it to offer. And all these, they feel like sort of gateways to places, gateways to certain states of mind.
I just, you know, when I lived in cities, I would, it's like you go into nature and, oh, you know, it's like something drops off. So, yeah, being here all the time is just, yeah, it's very good for me. And then I, from that space, I'm then able to give a lot more to people I've loved and known for a long time, and strangers and people that do my head in.
Be it like just looking at the grass as a kid and looking at all the bugs crawling around, or climbing trees or spending loads of time in the park, there was some sort of like, there was a knowingness to that world, and it didn't have to mean any more than it did. And then as an adult, I sort of feel like, God, I feel like I've lost something. I've lost some kind of essential connection to something. And I think that thing is nature. I think that thing is my environment, is life and its processes. Because it encapsulates so much. It encapsulates the whole cycle of life and death. And it's got so much to give us, more than just sort of poetic sentiment and metaphor. It's got real wisdom, and it's got real meaning to it.
How did they get that up there?
How did they get that up there? Yeah, that's what I'm saying, man.
I'm impressed that they managed to get a pallet up there, but I don't think the community would want them up that tree because they'd be worried about how dangerous it is.
Guys, be careful, because when you lower it off, obviously, there's going to be pressure on it.
Is that as dangerous as bringing it up?
Yeah, exactly.
Slowly.
Mind your foot that it doesn't wrap around your foot. There you go. Well done.
So you kind of have little benches underneath trees, and I want to also make this a deer-proof place. You imagine you come out of the main shrine room into another outdoor shrine. So you imagine that here you've kind of got quite colourful or fragrant flowers, lavender, honeysuckle, you know.
I think the two most important questions for every design are...
What have you got?
What have you got?
What have you got?
And what do you want?
What do you want?
What do you
That's
want?
Right.
I mean, I did consider that a priority... We're going to have more numbers once COVID's over. We're going to have much more volunteers.
Uh-huh.
And they're going to be camping. And the likely place to be is to the west of the walled garden.
Right.
So to get that sort of terraced... and flat.
And get a compost loo there.
A little bit there would be good.
Yeah, I've been thinking that last night, like compost loo is really useful.
So that would be phase one design.
Yeah.
Great, let's put a one to that.
Great. It's a multi-story car park. Candy Floss, yeah. And the William Wordsworth
theme park.
Theme park.
Oh, yeah, it's
gotta
be.
Yeah. Tesco Express in the walled garden.
So I was the site manager of the third climate camp at King's North Power Station.
Sounds stressful.
It was very stressful indeed, partly because the rest of my site crew were not allowed on site.
So she needs to be kept indoors pretty much until we get a spade. With the other cat, don't pick her up under the belly, because she might have loads of little kittens in there.
Yeah. Mm. So, I think she does, yeah.
And if you see the Tom, throw something at him.
What lawsuit? For innumerable hundreds of thousands of myriads of aeons,
one still could not exhaust the mighty flood of virtues. These bodhisattvas were named, I'm not going to read all of these, it's a long list. Samadarshana, Asamadarshana, Samadrivi Kuti Raja, Hramsa Vara, Dharma Ketu, Prabhaketu, Pradavyua, Ratnavyua, Mahavyua, Prati Bandakuta, Ratnakuta, Ratnapani, Ratna Mudra Drashta, etc., etc. It goes on and on. Kimnaras and Maharagas, as well as the realm of the four Maharajas and the king of mountains, Mount Sumeru, Mount Himadari, Mount Munchalinda, Mount Maha Munchalinda, Mount Gandhara Mandana, Mount Ratna Pravata, Mount Kalapravata, Mount Kanat, yeah, so there's all these mountains. All the great oceans, rivers, bays, torrents, streams, brooks.
Poor thing. She's got quite big nipples as well. Has she? Yeah. That
dirty
Tom. Oh no. It's terrible. Imagine if they both had kittens. We're
keeping the air locked on. Yeah.
Come on.
We
can go out.
Are you sure about that? Oh.
It was locked down, so I thought, I'll come down, I'll volunteer, I'll help straight away. And after about a week of being here and cooking, I went to Triratna and said, could I just maybe stay? Like, I mean, could I just stay? Yeah. I have to take this outside and spin this salad now. I hate it when the plates don't match. Here we go. The time of the bell will be 1:15. Lunch is served.
Keep it boiling.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So feel free to come back in a bit of seconds if you're so hungry. You're welcome.
Five past. We're getting later every day, people. Come on.
Chop.
It's all for your benefit. It's helping you.
It's helping me grow spiritually.
It is. It's helping your spiritual progress. Working in the cottage. Some days I really enjoy it, and some days I get a sense of sort of like motivation and progress, and I feel enthusiastic. And then other days I just feel like, oh God. There's also a sense of like, I'm not a decorator, I'm not a builder, but like there's just certain things I don't know what I'm really doing, so yeah, there's that. So obviously I've just been feeling a bit like unmotivated and getting frustrated and short-tempered with it all.
Initially, going back into the cottage, I just felt the same. Even though I was just going back in, I was like, But then I kind of got into it, more or less. But it's still just, it's just dusty and just, yeah.
It's interesting that people are talking about being feeling irritated or stuff. I kind of like me and irritation, we're just like that, you know. We're like good old friends. He's kind of around most of the time, really. Really, just like trying to be present with my experience. Anyway, just thought I'd say that. Actually, quite a good mood though today, really, to be perfectly honest.
An easily swayed mind has no strength, like the rain pouring into a badly roofed house. Craving cannot break into a strong and understanding mind, just as the rain does not break into a well-thatched house.
Maybe we could decorate outdoors today.
Yes!
What trees?
You could do what? Paint
decorate outdoors.
Decorate outdoors.
Paint the grass.
Yes, right.
You just a little bit. It's okay. Okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Oh, there's another one coming. There it is. There's three. It's okay. It's okay. You're okay, baby. I know. It's okay. That's right. Good mama.
Yeah, we can rejig it, but as a contest, it's fantastic, yeah.
if it's in the wind.
The wedding guest sat on a stone. He cannot choose but hear. And thus spoke on that ancient man, the bright-eyed mariner. And now the storm blast came, and he was tyrannous and strong, and struck with his overtaking wings and chased us south along. At length did cross an albatross. Thorough the fog it came, as if it had been a Christian soul. We hailed it in God's name. God save thee, ancient mariner, from the fiends that plague thee thus. Why look'st thou so? With my crossbow, I shot the albatross.
Comes just stripping it, I'll pay you cash.
No, well, let's see what there is.
£5, man.
Yeah.
Right, that's £8 out of your wages now. You ain't having bog paper for a week.
Yeah.
That would have been painful, that.
Dumped off your three heads.
Oh, I would have pissed myself, and he would have had it on the video, and we would have got £250. You've been framed. Oh, yeah. Do it again.
Yeah,
yeah. Say cheese.
Not you guys, and I'm just like, you know,
where are all the admin Buddhists, eh?
I was looking last night at something I've heard people talk about called Arma Platter.
Oh yeah, yeah. I've never managed to do an Arma Platter.
Oh, those are really cool looking. They're really interesting. So you've got your legs wrapped around your opponent on full guard. You turn to the side, and with your knee, you lift it up between their arms. Your leg goes up over their shoulder. That then crosses in front of their head as you turn over, and their hand bends back like this. It's
basically a Kimura.
It's a Kimura.
I've tried it on you a few times, I've not managed. I didn't notice.
Into the floor,
yeah.
And you're lifting my elbow off the ground whilst moving it further south. Like that.
Yeah.
That's it, it's great.
Okay.
Okay.
So you're gonna try doing that as if I'm defending myself.
Okay.
Yes!
Sorry.
Timber!
Oh, it's going to be a good one, this.
Should I just add that this is for tick protection and I don't normally walk around with knee-high socks and shorts on? I haven't had one yet, but some people get covered in them.
Some people.
Me! And then Nicola's got a really good technique for getting them out. You like lick your finger and cover them in spit and then like go clockwise and then they just kind of pop out.
Definitely appreciating the feminine energy around. That's what got me out of the tent this morning was the thought of working with Rachel.
No!
It really was. I was getting into that mood of like, oh, I'm tired, I can't be bothered. And then I just thought, oh, we're working with Rachel. And she's only got a couple of days left. And yeah, that really boosted us to get out the tent and do it.
Well, it is a mixed community for sure. In a way, because it started out a bit mixed, it needs to be more mixed because, you know, Nicola's not Buddhist, she's probably not going to stay long. Alana hopefully is. So, you know, there needs to be more women. Because at the moment, it must be pretty weird. You know, all those blokes.
There's been, you know, major clashes and irritations and things that have kept me awake at night, grinding my teeth. But then there's also been forgiveness of myself and of others and coming together in a stronger sense of like love.
It's so lovely to be in a place where the guys are just are so open and so supportive of each other.
I think often people, well, men and women can go through life just quite shut down and ignoring, you know, kind of turning a blind eye to their own struggles. And I think it's really important to put in the work for yourself to just be a better version of yourself.
First enlightenment, then the laundry.
Yeah, I know that my brother's really benefited from being here and having space to go further with emotions.
Well, I think I found in friendship in the past quite a difficult thing to come by. I'd use the word friends, like, as we all have. You know, I've got friends, I know friends, these people have become friends, despite the amount of time I'd known people sort of fizzled out. And I feel like those friendships were missing a certain quality and certain actions and behaviours that are found here, sort of motivated by kindness and genuine curiosity and inquiry into another person's life, rather than assumptions about who people are.
Obviously, people will come and go, volunteers will come and go, you know, for a whole variety of reasons, but hopefully being able to see the difference, different qualities people bring and finding space for themselves, there's space for everyone to contribute. You know, I like what David White says about friendship, that we see the shadow and the failings of our friend, but that's not what we relate to. We relate to the whole of them and we relate to the best part of them, even when it's difficult for them to be in touch with that.
So, you know, it's those relationships, in a way, that make me feel this is a really special place.
Cutie cuties! Where's my cutie babies? Cutie. Hi, babies. Hi, sweeties. Do you want to wake up?
Fish fry.
Oh, she's
You're an anxious bunches. You're an anxious bunches. You're rambunctious. Rambunctious, anxious.
So, detailed info to give to guests when they arrive. They come in, got their test, they read the information sheet, and then someone then takes them around. So I guess first they need to know where they're going to put their tent. So I think two options. If they like it really quiet, walled garden. Otherwise, there.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And then when they're up there, we show them where the men and women's toilets are.
Mm-hmm.
If they want gender neutral, they've got all of the land.
Thank you.
Yeah, so that's an edible one. It is. Edible. So now we need to. Oh, yeah, so that's that one then.
Yeah, I mean, there's a big patch there.
There was.
Pick more of
them. Although they're quite a different colour underneath.
Yeah, so that yellow one's the salt. I think it's the sulphur nightcap.
Oh, the one with the skull and crossbones beside it. See how much moisture is there?
Wow.
You want to get rid of all that froth, basically.
I'm going to go up to Alaska, where I was born and raised. It'll be the first time that I've really returned sort of home, as you say, you know, in 27 years. It's kind of a going back to lay some old ghosts to rest kind of thing. I mean, it's my life is forever changed for the better for having been here. So, you know, whilst, you know, my preferred mode of living and being may be to live alone in a nice clean little flat where everything has a place and it's always put back where it belongs. There's only so much personal growth and the development that can come up if you're, you know, encapsulated in your own little world where you don't rub up against things and you don't rub up against other people. What I'm gonna miss most is I'm gonna miss feeling seen. Living here with a group of individuals who are all doing their best to be conscientious of one another. That's really special. Okay. Thank you so much, Tara. Yeah.
See you soon.
We'll see you soon.
Yeah.
Right.
Woohoo! Woohoo!
We've got enough money to last us into the spring, but after that, we run out of money. Obviously, we had a main benefactor who bought the property, and he'd also promised to fund the ongoing building work on the project.
Over the winter months, it was tough last winter. There's no heating, you know. I was in a tent. I was finding it tough, just the challenge of the job, but also the demands of living, you know, living on a building site with no heating 24/7. So I was keen to say to him, you know, we do need more money next year, so are you going to release more Bitcoin? And he had said he would release Bitcoin when it hit 16,000, and then he said, well, when it reaches 25. I think I contacted him when it was at 33,000 a coin, and he still didn't want to release it. And then when it went over 40, I sort of said, look, you know, I'm not saying release it all, you know, just 10%. 10% or even 5% will help us have the confidence that I've got the resources, the financial resources for the next 18 months, because we want to do the roof. So I had a number of phone calls with him, and then eventually he sort of said to me, "Gerald, I don't want you to mention Bitcoin again in any of our conversations." So I went, okay, fine.
Yeah, I feel quite a lot better than yesterday. I did fast until supper time. That was good. it's fantastic to see things coming together. I feel like Annex room is coming together, and the outside of the coach house is really resolving and looking smart. You know, it's just very satisfying. That's me. Uh-huh.
It's, you know, it's been magnificent. And though, you know, it's hard work and challenging conditions in many ways, it is fantastic. You know, it's just such a sense of camaraderie and playfulness and the deepening bonds of friendship. Engaged in something that's magnificent.
Okay. Can you hear how the acoustics have changed in this room?
Yeah.
I do this for minutes. So I would do this. You want to stand there, and then you could do all those down.
Almost sounds good.
Yeah, you're right. If we're doing this part, we should do it.
Get a job.
We're cleaning your shrapnel. Cleanse him.
He's like,
the brown note.
Yeah. No, I don't want to be in that.
That was a bum note. Yeah,
that's a bum note.
Okay, Dharma input. Still on the Pranya Paramita of Virya. Energy in pursuit of the good. And one of the other qualities I think is associated with Virya is determination. So you kind of have a goal and you sort of keep sort of rising to the challenge. You know, something kind of obstructs you. You kind of, all right, how can I kind of keep going? What do I need to do? Once the spring comes, we've got a whole series of retreats of different things. We've got a swimming pool renovation retreat. You've probably never heard of a swimming pool renovation retreat, but my hope is that people will sort of think, oh, that, I quite fancy that, you know. And actually we're combining that with a dance teacher, and she's going to do dance in the evening. So it's a swimming pool renovation retreat with mindful dance. You know, there's this famous story of Robert the Bruce and the spider, which you may have heard, where Robert the Bruce is in a cave and the Scottish army has been defeated and he's hiding in a cave. And he watches this spider trying to spin its web and it kind of swings over and misses, swings over. And then on the sixth time it manages and he sort of thinks, yes. So yeah, keep going. Keep working with your mind. Determination. The end.
Okay. Which they can't find. Devari, Omami, Devari, Omami, Devari, Omami, Devari, Omami, Devari.
Oh, mommy, Devari.